And now, your First Alert 5 weather.
Things are relatively quiet here in southeastern Colorado. You notice from I-25 out and towards the Kansas border, nothing is showing up on radar. However, we do have some isolated pockets to talk about here in the Sangre de Cristo Mountains. Here's the southern part of it. We're looking at the San Luis Valley out towards the left-hand side of your screen, I-25 to the right-hand side, and we've got a couple areas already with some of these light showers and thunderstorms that are moving over the Spring Burn Scar area. So we have some aerial flood advisories, and that ends until 7:30 this evening, as well as for 7:15 this evening for Costilla and Huerfano counties for mostly the western section of the Spring Burn Scar. And we're going to continue to monitor all those burn areas over the next couple of hours, because all of these light thunder showers are producing quite a bit of rainfall, but that's also because they're not really having a lot of momentum to kind of spread that rainfall out. A couple of light rain showers here in the northern Sangres as well as the northern San Luis Valley at this hour. Other than that, though, just a lot of clouds up there in the sky. Right now, the current temperature is 89 degrees here in the Springs. Winds are fairly strong here in the northern half of El Paso County. A little bit lighter down there in southern Pueblo County, where the current temperature is 95 degrees. And check this out, 19% relative humidity. That's very dry air out there, and that plays a big part in our forecast. Other temperatures in this area at this time, we're looking at 90s out in the eastern plains with 98 in La Junta, 86 in Walsenburg, 90 for Trinidad, 74 in Westcliff, and 70s checking in from the San Luis Valley. The wind speeds out there, as I mentioned, a little bit stronger here in El Paso County, but fairly light in other areas, anywhere from about 5 to 15 miles an hour, but it's also, again, very dry. Now, this is surface air that we're talking about here, where the relative humidity values are in the teens and 20s, so we don't have a lot of moisture to work with here at the surface. In the upper levels, we still have plenty, and that's why we have quite a bit of cloud cover. So where we do have some of those rain showers, if they manage to move out into the I-25 corridor later on this afternoon and this evening, there's a very slim chance that we'll actually feel any of that rain, because it's just too dry at the surface. Now, this is what I'm talking about here on the water vapor loop, where you see an area of white here and we get into the blues and the greens. This is a lot of moisture, but it's in the upper levels of the atmosphere. We don't have any down here at the surface. So until the entire column of air is completely saturated, it's very difficult for us to see any of that rainfall. So we're going to keep the rain in the mountains for tonight as well as for tomorrow. But it's going to be, again, difficult for us to generate any showers and thunderstorms here from I-25 out into the eastern plains. What we need is not only moisture, but we also need kind of a trigger mechanism in the atmosphere. So let's get into that here. And over the next couple of hours, here are those scattered showers and thunderstorms. Maybe a few of them start to get close to the I-25 corridor over the next couple of hours. But as we head into 9, 11 o'clock, some of that moisture will start to spill out over here. I can't rule out just maybe a sprinkle or two as we head into the overnight hours. And it looks a lot more serious than it really is, as we're talking about some very light rain showers as we head into tomorrow morning on Monday. And then for tomorrow afternoon, once again, another round of spotty showers and thunderstorms in the mountains, again, isolated in nature by the time they make it out to the I-25 corridor for tomorrow afternoon. Forecast details look like this on the 7-day, 89 here in Colorado Springs, and I'm keeping it isolated. Now, despite the fact that there might not be an icon with a thunderstorm over the next 7 days on some of these forecasts, that doesn't mean that we're completely void of the thunderstorm chances. It just becomes much more isolated in nature and really didn't warrant a complete icon. So when you take a look at Pueblo, for example, for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, you notice the verbiage on the bottom, it says isolated. So there is still a slight chance for a thunderstorm to eke its way out onto the I-25 corridor. But you notice the temperatures also, they start to increase over the next couple of days. That's when it's going to be the warmest for the next 7 days. But as we get to Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, that ridge of high pressure starts to break down, move off to the east, and that's when we get more moisture working into the state, as well as kind of a less stable atmosphere to really help generate some of those